Okay guys, so today we are going to be doing a review, actually a pretty long awaited review for me, on a really awesome knife that I have been looking forward to reviewing and just looking forward to owning for many years. This is kind of one of my kind of sub grail knives, so I have my grail knives, but this is one of those sub ones that I really wanted, but it wasn't super expensive. Anyways guys, before we get into this, as always, do not forget to comment, like, share, and subscribe so that you can continue to see more awesome Alaskan EDC outdoor and survival content. Let's get into this. So that knife that was mentioned before is the good old Microtech Ultratech, and this knife has been one of those knives that I've wanted for a very, very long time. And it actually took me quite some time to get because, as far as it goes, my channel, before I really made EDC content prevalent, my channel really didn't have a space for this type of knife. So I would have the money and the types of knives, I'd have very expensive knives, more expensive knives than this one, but I would never really get this knife, the Microtech Ultratech, because I didn't really have a good way to explain it, I didn't have a good form to review it, and a whole bunch of different reasons why. And so I kind of just ended up never shelling out this much money for an EDC knife because of those reasons. But now that the channel is doing a bit more EDC content, I've decided to go ahead and get some of these more awesome kind of EDC knives that I've always wanted. And this is one that initially I didn't quite want until I got an Ultratech, which was just a single edge version, just more like an EDC version. Then I got this one after I fell in love with that one and was like, oh my goodness, this is an awesome defensive knife, and this is actually my top defensive option. Now the reason why I'm showing you guys this one is because this review is going to be specifically on the Microtech Ultratech Tri-Grip pattern. And for those who don't know, Microtech makes their Ultratechs in many, many, many different pattern styles, flavors. They make double edge, they make plain double edge, they make serrated double edge, they make double edged serrated versions, they make hellhound versions, they make tanto, single edge drop points, a whole bunch of them. They make double edged tanto called the Spartan versions, and just a whole plethora of different things. They also make multiple different handle versions. So this one here reviewed is the Tri-Grip. I'm going to be rolling in some pictures of my two Tri-Grips, and so you guys can get an idea of what a Tri-Grip looks like. Pretty soon here, coming soon, I will have a contoured grip version of it, which is basically like this but without the Tri-Grip pattern on it. So they make flat, just plain aluminum handles, then they make contoured handles, they make Tri-Grip handles, frag handles is what they call them. It's kind of meant to replicate the grip on a fragmentation grenade, and so they make frag handles, they make a whole bunch of different things. I could go on, I could do legitimately a 20 minute video just on all the different Microtech Ultratech variants out there, and I'm not even getting into the UTX 85 or 70. So anyways, like I was saying, this video review is going to be specifically on the Tri-Grip pattern, both single edge and double edge. Just for those who know, due to my lack of huge budget and these knives being kind of expensive, not super expensive, I've been able to get these used on Blade forums and Facebook for around $200 to $190. So they're not super expensive, but they are very awesome, very, very nice. There's a little bit of rattle in the blade, but that's to be expected with most out the fronts. But for the most part, a very nice knife made of Bowler, I think it's Bowler L-Max steel. I'm not sure if Bowler makes L-Max or not, but I know it's L-Max steel for these. Almost all of the Ultratechs are an L-Max, which L-Max is a steel that I've had a little bit of experience on. Like I was going to say, the reason why I only have one for show, you guys are probably familiar with my single-edged teal version, and I decided to actually let that knife go because I wanted a knife to do other Ultratech reviews. So I actually got a black contoured handled version. So basically I sold off the blue one and bought a contour handled single edge, just plain UltraTech for that, because I actually wanted a just plain handled one. I didn't want just two tri grips. So anyways, that's a long explanation, but expect that review in the future too once I get it. But anyways, so that's why I just have this double edged version, but this is speaking on my experience, because I did use in review, I did use both my single edge and my double edge. For, I didn't really use the double edge for much EDC tasks, but I did use my single edge for a lot of package opening, and it worked very well. The edge retention was very good on them. The only thing I will say about these knives is they're not very good. This is speaking about both, all really UltraTechs, is because MicroTech puts a very, very thin grind, and you guys will be able to see this in the pictures I'm rolling in, because they put a really thin grind or a very small, shallow grind on their blades. It makes it, not that it's dull, because these knives are very sharp, and you guys could see, I'm gonna be rolling in some cut footage here. You can see that both of these edges are very sharp. Both the serrated and plain edge are very sharp edges. So they're definitely sharp enough to cut, especially cutting open packages. And I have actually done some cutting open packages in this. I don't really love to pull this knife out to cut open packages, because it's a really scary looking knife when you just go like this and it flies out. It's all like a dagger and everything. But if no one's looking, I might just pop this and just like cut something, because it cuts really well. It really does. Like, you might not expect a dagger to actually be that fieldable and usable, but this is actually a very useful dagger. But anyways, so the edge behind, or the steel behind the edge is really thick, so this does not, all of what I've experienced with all my MicroTech UltraTechs is that they do not like to slice things like paper. So I actually have a really hard time slicing phone book paper, which is an arguable test. It's not very realistic, but it is a test of edge, like how sharp your edge is in most cases, but not in the case of this type of knife, because there's just so much steel right behind the edge. And that's even more so on the double edge, because unlike in a single edge where the actual height, full height of the grind is more toward the back of the edge, like about here, when you make a double edge, you have to center the maximum height of your steel. So the maximum height of the steel is actually down the center of the edge, as opposed to being more toward one side. So that kind of makes both grinds on a double edge inherently thicker. However, this is still a very usable knife for if you do need to, for that rare occasion, if you need to cut open like a cardboard box, or if you need to do some kind of EDC task, this will do it. But I would recommend for two reasons. One, that it's gonna not be as effective as a normal knife, say, you know, the ZT0452, where this is actually, you know, a dedicated EDC knife, you know, has a way better slicing edge. This would be my recommended EDC choice, but that, and also the intimidation factor. If you whip this out and you just, you know, fire it, it's going to scare some people, because it's a pretty intimidating and scary looking knife, especially for those who aren't in the know. So anyways, so overall, as far as a MicroTech goes, this is a 2015 model. So for the 2015 year, and this changed in 2016, and I'm gonna roll in a picture of my 2016 tri-grip and my 2015 tri-grip. You'll notice that the 2015 tri-grip does not have a flat spot here where the pocket clip contacts the actual grip material. So the one negative I do have, and this has been alleviated on the newer 2016 and forward UltraTech tri-grip models, is that it does shred your pants pretty badly if you are drawing this in and out of your pocket with frequency. So do keep that in mind, that the older 2015 and older tri-grip models will not have that special flat out area for the pocket clip, just so that's noted. But that is fixed on the 2016 and up models. So anyways, other than that, it's a really, really great, it's a really great UltraTech. I have no real issues with it. I will say, and I'm not sure if this was a single edge problem or if they downgraded the spring tension. I'm gonna find out soon, because I'm gonna be getting another UltraTech. But I will say that my 2015 model deploys harder than my 2016 model, and it also requires more strength, like in your thumb. It's not a significant more strength, but it's noticeable that you need to have more strength when sending it in or out with your thumb. You need to be able to push or pull like that harder, but it's not super, super hard. So aside from that, those are all the kind of technicalities. Hopefully I haven't bored you guys yet, but the action is really fast. Like I said, it's a little bit stiffer on this version, but I kind of like that, especially in a double-edged version, because I like my blade coming out with a little bit more authority. It also helps that when the blade cools down, like say I lay this here on the snow like this and it begins to cool down, it's pretty warm right now because I'm holding it in my hand and it's not particularly cold outside. But what I experienced with my other Microtech is because it had a weaker spring, whenever I would fire the blade like this, and actually it nearly did it that time, but whenever I'd fire the blade, it would be so cold that the action would, the springs would kind of seize up because the oil that's put in here to help the springs lubricate and stay nice and fresh and fun, that stuff cools down and actually begins to slow the springs down. So I like this harder deploying and firing action that this particular double edge has. I'm not sure if that's just with this one or if my other one just was used a lot more. It could have been, not exactly sure. But anyways, I've noticed that this one's a lot harder firing. But aside from that, going on to the actual, or not a lot harder firing, but a little bit harder firing. So aside from that, going on to the actual handle of the tri-grip, because like I said, this is a tri-grip review, I've noticed that the tri-grip is extremely grippy. Now, in fairness, to be completely honest to you guys, I have never held a Microtech that didn't have tri-grip handles on it, so I can't speak to what a normal micro grip or Microtech has, but I have held stuff like the Benchmade AF02 or owned. I own a Benchmade AF02, and so for the AF02, it had aluminum handles too, and they weren't really like milled like this here, so they were definitely a little bit more slick, especially when it got cold outside. They got really slick and hard to hold onto. They were not fun handles to hold onto at all. So this though is a completely different animal because of the amount of cuts and the amount of like triangles here all over the handle. This is an extremely grippy handle, and one of the reasons why I'm keeping this tri-grip always as my defensive knife, and the reason why I kind of chose this as my defensive option, was because when you do lock your hand, when you grab this knife like this, or when you actually put some force behind this like handle, you know, like when you're actually gripping it, these tri-grips, you guys won't really be able to see my hands, but my hands get really marked up by all these triangles, and it grips up really, really strong. So that's kind of what I like about this knife being a defensive knife, is that there is no question in my mind that this knife, when I hold it like this, it's not going anywhere. My hand has a full grip on all of these triangles, and about half of these triangles here are all digging into me, and I'm not gonna break traction. Should I need to slash? Should I need to do anything with this knife that's defensive? The handle's not going anywhere. I'm not gonna slip. I'm not gonna break traction. I'm not gonna lose traction. In addition to this, the tri-grip pattern knives, they use a more aggressive styled on and off, kind of forward and back switch. I'm not exactly sure what you want to call this, but it's a switch, and it uses an X pattern. It's basically like an ascending X pattern, and this ascending X pattern is super grippy, especially when you're using things like mechanics gloves and thicker, heavier materialed gloves. It really grabs, and so you can more easily deploy this knife with gloves on than a traditional or standard Microtech, because the traditional and standard Microtechs, they kind of use a stair step. This is something I've seen on them, is they use a stair step kind of switch here, which is not bad at all. I think that works, especially when it's this just the skin of your thumb, but when you go over to a tri-grip, it actually uses this ascending X pattern. And I don't know, you guys won't be able to see my thumb, but my thumb can definitely show the whole fact of how ripped up it gets when you do deploy this on and off a lot. So I do want to keep in mind too that if you're one of those guys kind of like me who likes to sit here and play with your switchblade and open, close, this would not be my recommended version for you guys, because it really rips your thumb up. And if you do this for any length of time, like forward, back, for any length of time during a day, your thumb will get really sore because this is a very, very aggressive pattern. So just to keep that in mind. Other than that though, as far as this being more of a combative grip and a combative setup, I really do like the tri-grip. It's not my absolute favorite for EDC, and that was one of the reasons why I ended up turning in my, or not turning, I shouldn't say that, but why I sold my tri-grip single edge, is because for an EDC knife, I think that the tri-grip is probably a little bit much. I think it's a little bit overboard because it honestly kind of tears up your thumb, and when you're just like going to open some little package like that, it's not really great for that. But when you're going for more industrious tasks, like having a defensive blade like this one, it can be really handy. Anyways, guys, hopefully you've enjoyed this and it hasn't been too rambly. And as always, God bless, and I'm out.